There is so much bullshit. So much bullshit everywhere. We're drowning in it. Drowning in bullshit. So many reasons, right? Politicians are unconstrained by the facts these days, it seems. Science, my area, is conducted by press release more than it is carried out in the journals. Higher education, if you don't know this by now, you guys are seniors, higher education rewards bullshit over analytic thought. Startup culture, we're here on the West Coast. Startup culture has become sort of an elevation of bullshit to high art. A generation ago, advertisers fed us bullshit straight up, just plain bullshit. Now here's just plain bullshit. But now it's more subtle. Now they use irony as this sort of Trojan horse. They invite us to join them. They kind of wink and say, oh, well, you know, laugh along with us at all the bullshit. And so we wink and we laugh along at all the bullshit. And then our guard goes down and then they slip second order bullshit in underneath all of that, right? Administrative activity basically amounts to a sophisticated exercise in the combinatorial reassembly of bullshit. These days, Americans spend nearly an hour a day on Facebook. Doing what? Mostly spreading bullshit. Enough! Enough bullshit! We are tired of this.
Really, it is enough. Bullshit really invades all aspects of our life, and I think that's partly why a lot of you are here today. I mean, maybe because you saw the word bullshit in the class title and you thought, oh, I'll take a class that has the word bullshit in it. And maybe some of you are like, one credit? That's an easy class I can end, because a lot of you are seniors. We looked at the list, and you're from all over. But it's more than just what Carl said. It's more than just startup hype. It's more than advertising bullshit. This can get real. It can be life or death. And when the shit gets real, that's when we should care as a society. So it may sound a little melodramatic, but Carl and I really think that these are the kinds of skills, sort of refuting bullshit, identifying bullshit, are the things that we need in today's society more than ever. More than important than any other class I teach in the areas of data science. And there's infinite examples, but let me start with a recent example that many of you have probably seen. So before I give any sort of credit to this particular article, you certainly could classify this as fake news. This was an article that was posted on AWD News, and it claimed that the Israeli defense minister was basically threatening Pakistan because of what was happening in Syria. Now, you know, when you read this sort of thing, it seems really kind of ridiculous as I say this. And many of you, I know, have the skills. You don't need this class to be able to identify most of the bullshit that's out there. You could look at this and you could say, that sounds ridiculous. And if something sounds so grandiose, so sort of silly, it probably is. And we'll talk a little bit about this throughout this class. But this one started to elevate. Shit did get real. This is a real thing if you hadn't seen this. And this scared me. I mean, I start to lose sleep about these kinds of things. I have kids. I care about living, I guess. And there's this defense minister from Pakistan. You know, he's trying to defend his country, and he saw a threat. And so on Twitter, he says this. Israeli forgets that Pakistan also is a nuclear threat as well. This is crazy. And there's the tweet from the actual Ministry of Defense in Israel saying this was false, and later on it was accepted and it was sort of identified as fake. But this sort of thing is happening all the time. And this is something that we can sort of laugh about the advertising, and we can laugh about some of the other areas that sort of infiltrate our lives, but these things are sort of can be life and death. One particular quote that really stuck with Carl and I when we were thinking about putting this together recently was this quote that Mark Galati talked about. And I'm just going to read it. I know you can read it yourself, but I want to sort of really sort of emphasize what he's trying to say here. Instead of trying to combat each leak directly, the United States government should teach the public to tell when they are being manipulated via schools and non-government organizations and public service campaigns. Americans should be taught the basic skills necessary to be savvy media consumers, from how to fact-check news articles to how pictures can lie. And this really sort of resonated with us. What we do, what Carl and I do for a living, what we get paid by your tax dollars, is to spend a lot of time calling bullshit, but in science. We do a lot of peer reviewing of articles. We do peer reviewing of proposals and reports. That's what we get good at. Now, we can always get better. But in this new information environment that we live in of misinformation, Carl and I thought, why don't we put something together that gives to students and to all people, not just the students here at UW, the tricks and the methods that have been talked about actually for centuries, but also with an emphasis on data. How can we give this back to the community on all sides of the political realm? A lot of people, a lot of reporters have asked us, is this a swipe at the Trump administration? And as much as there's some things about what's going on that really that bothers Carl and I, this has been something we've been thinking about for several years. And again, we're not the only ones to talk about it. So we decided to release we started to put together a site. We started doing this a couple of years ago, and we officially released it in January. And this was really our way of giving back to the community and to the investment that's been given to us to learn these kinds of skills. And again, I want to emphasize, when you teach a class, a lot of times you do it because you want to get better. We also want to get better at doing this sort of thing. So we put this class together, and we like our quotes. I'm going to show you a couple more quotes, but this is what cemented it in for us, these kinds of things. So John Alexander Smith was giving a speech to Oxford students in 1914, and he said this. My favorite part, of course, is the talking rot, but we'll get there in just a second. So nothing that you will learn in the course of your studies at the University of Washington will be of the slightest possible use to you in the afterlife, after school. Save only this: if you work hard and intelligently, you should be able to detect when a man or a woman or any gender is talking rot. And that, in my view, is the main, if not the sole purpose of education. And we wholeheartedly agree with this.